Stay tuned for the biggest fish, the hottest bites, this week here on In-Depth Outdoors. With James Holst.
Look at that. Wow, is that an incredible fish?
And the rest of the IDO fishing team. We're headed to the best fisheries across the upper Midwest and Canada. We'll fish longer, explore unfished bodies of water, and go further off the beaten path in search of the hottest bites in fresh water. With Pat McSherry.
All right, what a fish.
Andy Fioco.
Wow.
Get the colors on this fish.
And Mike Anselmo.
Man, he's bumping.
This is In-Depth Outdoors.
Thanks for tuning in to another episode of In-Depth Outdoors. I'm James Holst, and today's show is all about making that transition from ice fishing to open water. Now our plan was to head to Green Bay to fish with Paul Delaney, as we had in the last couple seasons to kick off our open water episodes. So here's what happened, and allow me to start with a fishing report from Oconto Peshtigo. So Paul Delaney fished on Monday, had 5 fish. Paul Delaney and I fished on Tuesday and had 6. Let's just say that bite is not ready yet. The water is far too cold, it's very clear, and there just hasn't been a lot of wind. So when you pull into those shallows around the river mouths of Oconto and Peshtigo, what you see is a lot of walleyes in very clear shallow water that just aren't ready to eat yet. So we're probably about a week, maybe 10 days away from that bite really firing up. So what did we do for today's show? Now, the Fox River near De Pere has been on a better walleye bite. Now, you typically don't get as many big fish out of the Fox River as you do out of Oconto Peshtigo on average, but there is a lot of walleyes up in the river. Now, on the day that Paul and I were gonna fish, we were looking at some pretty horrible conditions for a spring walleye bite. Overcast, cloudy, drizzly, and very cold. So I do have a technique that I really love to use in this situation. It's one that I think anybody who likes to fish spring walleyes needs to add to their arsenal. It's certainly not a technique that I invented, but it's one that has saved me time and time again over the last 10 years. And that presentation is dragging jig and plastics upstream to entice very lethargic walleyes. So stick around. It's Paul Delaney and I today on the Fox River here on In-Depth Outdoors.
You got her?
We got her.
Right here, I mean, there's a real nice break to the channel here.
This is right where we're at, and we've got we'll be pulling against the current here, but we got a little wind to our back that should help boat control, and we can just kind of drag along this edge and find out where those puddles of fish are, and just kind of work back and forth over them.
Puddles. Okay, that'll work. I've always called them pods, but puddles. Fish.
Mm-hmm. Need a hand, James? Or
no, I got it.
Okay.
He's no giant.
Oh, I just missed one.
What we're doing here to start the morning is we're just dragging super slowly upstream into the current, about half a mile an hour. And we're fishing quarter ounce heads with some pretty bright plastics. And what that does in this dirtier water, it allows these walleyes a long time to eyeball that bait before it swims away. And he hit her pretty hard. That's a good sign. You know, these fish will get more active and more aggressive as the day goes on, you know, as the water temperature warms up. And to have a fish really crank on the bait to start the day, that's a good sign. See a fish.
Not the biggest one we'll see today, but it's a first.
He was my favorite one of the day so far, Paul.
Yeah. I think I missed one right in that same spot.
There he is, got him.
Heck yeah. Good fish or just
a
little shaker?
Small one. Not a big one, pretty much same size as James just caught, which is, there's a lot of fish in the system that are in that 17 to, oh, just lost them.
Boink.
17 to 21 inch range, but of course you got a shot at a real large fish here, and water temperatures are still a little bit cold here yet, but we got a shot at a big fish today, and I'm sure we'll see a number of those fish in our high teens and low 20s, but let me get back out there.
What color was that, Paul?
That one was on chartreuse
of
orange
course.
Core.
The old standby. There's fish. Boy, he didn't hit it hard.
Fish?
Yep, but he did not hit it hard.
Same color there?
Yeah, I'm just gonna, like I said, this is a little better fish,
One, yeah. I just saw a glimpse of him, but he was in the sun there.
Could you net that one for me, Paul?
Sure.
It'd be a little bit much to lift.
There we go.
Nice. Thank you. A little bit more of a quality fish. Might be a little female, maybe.
That looks to be. Looks like it's got a pudgy belly.
Boop. Same color. Chartreuse green. And like I said, I think that might be just a small female. Got a little bit of mass there in the middle. But don't we all? Nicer fish. See you later, little lady. Yeah. You know, fishing two rods like this and covering all this water, this is a technique where a guy can really put a bunch of fish in the boat in a very short amount of time. You know, if you've watched the shows over the years, you know that when we do these spring walleye trips, very often the early morning period, that first 2 or 3 hours is really pretty tough. And that bite just kind of continues to build throughout the course of the day. And typically that 3-4 o'clock time period is very often the best. You know, we've got a little bit more of a stained water condition here, some, you know, silt in the water. So once you kind of get into that lower light, presentations like this will fall off, and then we'll want to get real shallow, concentrated on an area where those big fish will be up in even shallower water, maybe throw a rip and wrap or a larger plastic. But for middle of the day, this dragon jigs is really a very efficient presentation for putting lots of fish in the boat.
Shallow wrap shad's a jerk bait with a secret move. When you pause, the lure slowly rises. I tell you, man, it makes fish come unglued.
Authentic Series soft baits from B-Fish and Tackle are just what the doctor ordered if you want to scratch your big fish itch. Available in two body styles, the Moxie Auger Tail and the Pulsar Paddle Tail offer a perfected blend of field-tested color patterns and hyperactive designs that come to life in the water. To produce unparalleled fish-catching movement and vibration, other soft baits just can't match. Authentic Plastics, your prescription-strength cure for slow fishing, only from B-Fish and Tackle.
Everything you'd expect from a premium quality fish house and so much more. Glacier combines superior craftsmanship and premium quality materials to produce a comfortable and enjoyable mobile base camp for your next outdoor adventure. Available in a variety of models, a Glacier Ice House offers more standard features, more usable space, and a better fit and finish than the competition. Visit our website at glacierIcehouse.com to find a dealer near you and see why a Glacier fish house is the ultimate way to play.
Uncompromising, like the fishermen who swear by it.
There's fish.
Fish?
Yep.
All right. I'm gonna grab the net for you on this one.
Would you please?
Seen him yet?
Not yet.
Okay.
Which is good. Decent female.
Tell you what, I'll reach from back here.
That fish is going nowhere.
There he is.
Thank you, Paul.
Yeah, there we
go. That's a much nicer fish there, Paul.
You bet. I just had one myself back there.
I saw the hook set. You gave her the beans.
It was in my left hand, so it's not my strong arm. Hey, that's a quality fish.
Yeah,
you know, it's not
we'll
a giant one, but a real pretty healthy one there.
Fatty female. And again, we've switched over to some darker colored bodies on our baits because we've lost that sun. And this is something that we always used to kind of treat as a, you know, a rule of thumb on the Mississippi River, and I guess it works here too. Wow, does that fish have that? Need a pliers, Paul.
Here you go.
Thank you. So we switched over to a purple chartreuse body. There we go. Real dark body, a little color there on the tail. I think when you lose the sun like this, those darker bodies are able to be kind of silhouetted in the water. Real nice fish, fatty female. We're gonna let her go. That one's got some tummy to it. I'd like to add about 5 or 6 inches in length to her though. Thanks for playing. All right. That's a couple females for me today. You know, when they get these tough spring conditions, you know, every one of these fish has to be earned. You know, in another week and a half, you get those water temperatures up, everything just cuts loose and gets so aggressive. Which, as you're seeing here today, you can still catch fish. Slow it down, you know, get rid of those real aggressive presentations. And of course, we're really having to refine our color patterns here today because, you know, when you've got this real dirty water, losing that sun makes everything that much more difficult. But those darker bodies really seem to do the trick.
There he is.
Good one?
Not bad.
Not bad, he says. Oh, yeah.
Nice. Yeah, it feels like a little bit better. It's that same bait. This time it was on that chartreuse green core, but a nice bump. You know, it's not a giant fish, but a little bit healthier.
How about I get this one out of the way? What color are you fishing?
This one is that
green core.
Chartreuse green core.
Really bright one.
I'm gonna guess this fish about the same size as the one we just caught a little bit ago here.
Oh, I'm hopeful that this one's bigger, Paul.
Oh, there we go. Good job. Ah. There we go.
All right, I got your other rod behind you, basically, so you're okay. In good shape.
Looks like another little female there. There we go. Boy, you can see how that fish just munched that bait down in the mouth there. That was a cool bite.
Yeah, you weren't going to miss that one, Paul.
No, that was one of those dunks.
Thank you.
There we go. So, yeah, not a giant fish. I'm going to guess fish maybe 17, 18 inches, but pretty healthy. Looks like a little female there. And
beautiful fish,
nice.
Paul.
Let's get that one back and head back up there, James. Nice. Oh, that's nice, refreshing, cold, 37 degree water.
In-depth outdoors, spot on the spot ID.
Where we had planned to initially fish with Paul earlier in the week was up here near Oconto, Peshtigo area. And this, of course, this is the whole arm of Green Bay. What we found there was very cold and clear water. The walleyes weren't up in the shallows in huge numbers yet, and those that were there just weren't that aggressive. So what we did is we relocated further south down near Green Bay. And that's where the Fox River rolls into the very southern portion of the bay. Now, the reason we chose to fish this area was the water was definitely dirtier, but it was also warmer, and the fish were a little more active. But that was before that cold front came in and kind of messed things up. Now, one of the things I love about dragging jigs in rivers is no matter how bad things get, it's a technique, it's a presentation that allows an angler to be very efficient, but also maximize their catch on a day when it can be very tough to put fish in the boat. So how we focused our attentions was really very simple. If you look in the center of the channel here on the Fox River, you see that they've got deeper water right down the center of the channel. So we would attack these deeper sections by fishing. You can actually see my plot trail. We dragged upstream on both sides of that deeper run of water. And you'll notice that you really can't see the big swings here because we're zoomed out a little bit, but I don't drive straight. But what I'm doing is I'm slowly sliding out in the deeper water, say 10, 11 feet, then I'll slide back up to 6, 7 foot of water. And what that's doing is it's changing the speed of lures on one side of the boat. When I turn away from the left side, the lures on the left speed up, the lures on the right slow down. They'll drag on the bottom a little bit. It's one of those deals that really helps keep those baits on the bottom. It allows you to get down into those little sand depressions and divots that are so common in rivers. And it's that change of speed that can do a wonderful job of getting very lethargic fish to commit. So if you're a walleye angler, you find yourself really struggling in the spring under cold front conditions, remember, troll those baits very slowly into the current, 0.4 to 0.7 miles an hour. Very slow movements of the rod tips, and choose plastics that offer a lot of body tail movement in the water when fished at slow speeds. What you'll be able to do is salvage a day when the bite was very difficult. And you can see in how our day is going, we're really starting to put a number of nice fish in the boat. So give this a try. I think you'll be very pleasantly surprised.
In pursuit of what lies beneath, Okuma Fishing Tackle is the point of connection between angler and opportunity, giant pike and muskie, drag screaming salmon, and deep-bodied lake trout, hard-fighting bass, and the elusive walleye, all pursued by anglers that demand the smoothest, longest casting reels and perfectly balanced fishing rods, engineered to perfection everywhere, every species. Okuma Fishing Tackle is inspired fishing.
Boat Center is now a full-service Warrior Boats dealer, offering the complete line of Warrior Boats, all covered by reliable Yamaha outboards. With dealerships located in Ramsey, Minnesota and Chippewa Falls, Wisconsin, Skeeter Boat Center carries more Warrior Boat models in stock than any other Warrior Boat dealer. No matter which Warrior model is right for you, you'll receive the same attention to detail and service after the sale that made Skeeter Boat Center the number one Skeeter dealer by volume in the Midwest. For the best selection of fiberglass fishing boats and unmatched service, stop in or visit us online at SkeeterBoatCenter.com.
Shallow wrap shad's a jerk bait with a secret move. When you pause, the lure slowly rises. I tell you, man, it makes fish come unglued.
Fish? It's a good one.
Got him?
Yeah.
Okay. How's he feeling?
If it's a walleye, it's a big walleye.
We love big walleyes.
Yes, we do. All right. Boat's off. I don't know why. I hate fighting fish wearing gloves.
I just hate gloves. Don't like cold hands, but I hate gloves, hate hoods.
Get that net ready.
Yeah, okay. Can you roll around the motor to the other side, James?
Yep, maybe. Nope. I think it's a carp. Just
too big, no head shakes.
No, let's try it. That's handy. Paul, that's a big walleye. That's a big walleye.
Oh, he's a good one. He's a good one. Yes. Yeah, I'm telling you, it's a big one. That's the one we've been looking for here, James.
I thought it was like going to be some kind of suckery, carpy quillback. Just fought too hard.
Oh, my goodness. Look at that
donk. I just switched colors, too. Paul had a couple there in a row on that white-looking ringworm. I put on a chartreuse white core moxie, and that is a stud of a walleye.
That's what it's about. You know, we've been talking all day how this is a trophy fishery. You don't always see them. A lot of times it's a night fishery for those guys, but they're here, and you got a shot at them at any time.
It's dark and overcast. It might as well be maybe night. I don't know.
You know, as tough as we've had it today.
That's an awesome fish.
You bet.
All right, let's get this girl back. That is a super tanker right there. Big, big, big girl. Oh, thank you. Oh, that was awesome. That fish completely had me fooled. I think what it is more than anything is they got such a strong upstream wind, it was just blowing us away from that fish.
Yeah. You know, it's just been a real tough deal. We've stuck with it here today. We've been working this area. We've got a lot of nice fish. That's by far the best fish that we could possibly get. And there's more of them in here. So let's get these baits back out there and do it again.
So the plastics that we've used today, they're all made by B-Fish and Tackle, and it's part of their Authentics plastic line. And, you know, one of the things that I think makes those B-Fish and Tackle plastics so perfect for this type of fishing is they come in some really good walleye colors. I mean, there's a lot of soft plastics on the market. Most of them are tailored to bass. B-Fish and Tackle is very specific. They've got a lot of cool walleye colors. And the second thing that I think you really need to look for when you're picking soft plastics for fishing walleyes in cold temperatures like this, you have to have a plastic body that's just got a real soft plastic with a tail that will give off a lot of action when you fish it slow. I mean, that's been our message all day long. How slowly can we move these baits? Now, if you fish with a plastic that has a, kind of a stiff body to it, that bait just basically slides through the water. There's no movement to it. So, you know, it's kind of hard to find baits like that, and B-Fish and Tackle offers some really good ones. And then we're combining those with that VMC quarter-ounce jig head, and we're moving forward upstream at about 4/10 up to almost 7/10 of a mile an hour. It really kind of depends on how much upstream wind we've got. At times I need to go a little faster just to keep control of the boat because the wind's blowing so hard, it's kind of pushing me around. So in that situation, I'll add a little speed to the boat so I can maintain control. But it's a very simple presentation. It's one that's bailed me out of tough bites in the spring time after time.
Authentic Series soft baits from B-Fish and Tackle are just what the doctor ordered if you want to scratch your big fish itch. Available in two body styles, the Moxie Auger Tail and the Pulsar Paddle Tail offer a perfected blend of field-tested color patterns and hyperactive designs that come to life in the water. To produce unparalleled fish-catching movement and vibration, other soft baits just can't match. Authentic Plastics, your prescription-strength cure for slow fishing. Only from B-Fish and Tackle.
In pursuit of what lies beneath, Okuma Fishing Tackle is the point of connection between angler and opportunity, giant pike and muskie, drag screaming salmon, and deep-bodied lake trout, hard-fighting bass, and the elusive walleye, all pursued by anglers that demand the smoothest, longest casting reels and perfectly balanced fishing rods. Engineered to perfection everywhere, every species, Okuma Fishing Tackle is inspired fishing.
At Aluma, we're in it for the long haul. That's why we make the longest lasting, most rugged trailers on the road. Flatbeds, bike haulers, tilt trailers, and enclosed. If you have a lot to move, we've got your way to move it. Our lightweight aluminum trailers will handle even your heaviest loads. At Aluma, we are right behind you with an industry-leading 5-year warranty. Because every trip and every load is valued.
There he is.
Atta boy.
Well, once again, like I said, sometimes we're pulling those baits and then sometimes I'm hopping them. When we've been getting into shallower stuff, I've been hopping them a little bit more, and that was exactly when that bait started to fall. I felt that peck and there he was.
Brown trout.
No.
What color did you get that one on?
This one's on the green core then.
Is it?
No, it's on the Moxie. But way out there, way. Soon as you stopped that boat, I took a long cast and we didn't go 20 yards and he was there.
Is it a girly?
I think it's a male. Usually they get bigger when we get closer. This one ended up getting smaller.
You had a lot of line out there. Nice fish.
Nice spring run river walleye anywhere. Even though we've got a lot of big fish out here and James had the privilege of catching a great big one a little bit ago, that's a great fish. Well, let's get this one back in because I have a feeling there's a bunch more fish right in front of us here. All right. Now that one, those last couple fish I caught were on that white ringworm, but this one again was on that chartreuse green core Moxie there with that quarter ounce VMC Moon Eye jig there. And so I guess getting a few on this one, then we'll get a few on the other one. James has got a couple different colors working for him, so we'll just keep him in the water and keep dragging him down this flat.
Fish.
Fish.
If I can catch up to him, there is.
Still got him?
This is not a color I was just about ready to get rid of.
No.
About ready to pull that firecracker off there.
Looks like he ate it pretty good though.
Well, it had to. I mean, I was all the way forward with my rod when it hit. So basically all I could do was just take my rod tip and point.
Jump forward.
All right. Ugh, come here. Yup. Just popped it. That's what makes fishing plastics for me so much fun. You know, you fish a jigging minnow and sometimes those fishes come up and just kind of grab onto it real delicate like and you set the hook, but when you're fishing plastics, even on a day like today when the fish are off, they still pop it. Fish.
Got him?
Got him.
You just
barely got settled. I barely got settled in.
Well, I'll reel in just in case we need to dip them with the net here.
Yeah.
I mean, we will.
I've seen the fox with a lot more current than this, but you were still bringing these fish up into the current and mixing a lot harder than it should be.
I think we can put a net on that one, huh?
Yeah. I mean, it's marginal net fodder, but I'll take it. You might scrape the 20 mark, maybe, upper teens.
He's a nice fish. There we go.
Yeah, thank you, Paul. I like that.
He munched on that one.
Yeah, for sure. Nice fish. You know, it's been a grind out day. Hasn't been easy by any means, but it sure beats sitting at home, wishing we'd gone fishing, belly aching about the weather.
We're not gonna do that.
We're not gonna do that, that's right. All right, fish, back you go. See you, bye. Those last two fish, Paul, I mean, 5-6 feet.
5-6 feet in about 25 seconds between the two.
Yeah. That's been our run for the day right there, those two. So when you're fishing two guys out of a boat dragging jigs like this, what I recommend is one guy in the bow to fish longer rods. These are 7-foot 1-inch Helio spinning rods, and I keep them out to the side like this. And what that does, it creates a nice spread between my lures. It gives Paul enough space so he can fish his rod straight up and down, and it really does a great job of avoiding tangles. Now, as far as how we're presenting the baits, we've discussed speed, and all I do is I kind of just drop my rod tip back on one side, feel for the bottom, there it is, slowly crawl it forward, and as I'm bringing this one forward, I'm dropping back, fish on. That's how it works. It's that slow little pump, one side to the next, that I think does a great job of convincing these fish to eat. So as one rod's coming back, the other one's coming forward. And then when you get to the top with that rod and you start dropping back, then the other one comes forward. Obviously it works. It's that same firecracker chartreuse that's been so hot here for about the last 45 minutes. And that's the Bee Fishing Tackle ringworm. I was about ready to take that off. Couldn't catch anything on it for a couple hours. Ready to take it off, and then they decided that I should keep it on there.
So that brings us to the end of today's show, and I want to thank everybody for tuning in, but I also want to thank Paul Delaney for taking time out of his very busy guide schedule to hop into a boat with me. Paul's one of my favorite guys to fish with, and he's one of our fan favorites. So if you're thinking about getting a guide who specializes in walleye, smallmouth, really just generally a fantastic fisherman on Green Bay, definitely look up Paul Delaney. That's lateyesportfishing.com. He'll definitely do you right. So next week, I think we're going to be heading to the Rainy River in northern Minnesota, where there's also a fantastic walleye bite taking place. So thanks for tuning in, everybody. We'll see you next week.
For more info on the latest fish reports, gear recommendations, and hottest techniques, connect with us online at indepthoutdoors.com or follow us on Facebook at In Depth Outdoors. And if you enjoyed today's show, be sure to let our sponsors know.